Welcome to my show, Dr. Olson. Indeed, thanks for inviting us to your beautiful and busy office in Phoenix, Arizona, where the recording is taking place. This show is intended for viewers and listeners in Korea, and I'll be direct and to the point with no warm-up. Here's my first question. You are a board-certified cardiologist, but you do things very differently, and you don't prescribe a blood pressure-lowering medication or cholesterol-lowering medications. And we'll get to that in a minute, but my first question would be, what made you a converted, and may I say word converted, cardiologist? What made you do things that you're doing right now? Very different than many other cardiologists out there.
Sure. I'm a board certified cardiologist. So I did 4 years of medical school, 3 years of internal medicine, 3 years of cardiology. So 10 years after college, I spent training and I finished up when I was 31. And I started off in practice and seeing the sickest of the sick people as a hospital cardiologist, doing angiograms and pacemakers. And it was kind of frustrating in the sense that patients didn't seem like they were really getting better. They weren't feeling better. You were putting them on all these pharmaceutical drugs for blood pressure, yet their blood pressure is still high. Or you put them on a cholesterol-lowering drug and they still have a heart attack. And I was getting very, once again, frustrated with that because you go into medicine to heal and to help people and to make them feel better. And I didn't feel like we were really doing that. And I was with the biggest group in the state of Arizona. There were 35 other cardiologists. I was a senior partner in that group. Well, along the way, I would meet the woman who would open up my eyes to the natural world, to reality, to becoming a doctor of cause. And she is a doctor of chiropractic, but a lot of times the chiropractors, as you know, like to say that they are DC's doctor of cause. So you find out what the cause of the health problem is and you remove it. And when we are able to do that and I'm able to institute that into my practice, that's how we get amazing results. So now I am also a doctor of causation and changed around my entire practice. I work to get people off pharmaceuticals, off those dangerous drugs, and actually go after why they have heart problems.
So you mentioned about being frustrated seeing those patients not getting better, actually getting worse on the medications. What happened to the other doctors, the other cardiologists?
Well, first of all, Dr. Cho, what I would say is that I really don't care about the opinion of the other doctors, right? Because people tend to speak against what they don't know. And they do so out of fear. They do so out of concern about the money factor. And the other doctors that I worked with were just not interested in what I had to say. If I talked about the fact that lack of sleep causes heart disease or lack of sunshine, they're just not interested in that because you can't make money from that. You can only make money seeing a lot of patients, recommending the pills, recommending the procedures, and that's what they do. I've lost all my MD and DO buddies, you know, from the past, and found a new set of friends that really get it. And I guess what's nice also, Doc, is that people in our space, in this health space, they're happier. You know, the doctors are happier. Working in the hospitals, the medical doctors are just kind of angry. They're just not happy. It's a frustrating way of life. It's an unhealthy way of life, and those doctors are so unhealthy. That's proven time and time again. Once again, I'm not worried about the old friends that I've lost. I'm happy for and grateful for the new friends.
That's a great answer. So should I assume that, like, most of the cardiologists, they don't have to change. They're just doing fine. Is that what it is?
Well, the cardiologists aren't going to change because, once again, it's a big paycheck, right? You know, that cardiologists in the United States make. When I left the group that I was with, I left there in 2012. I was making over $1 million a year in that kind of system. So how many people that are making that kind of money are going to give it up, no matter what it is?
Right.
Even if it's for the right reasons. And there's a famous book called The Jungle by Upton Sinclair. And in there is a quote, "It's hard to get a man to understand something when his job depends on him not understanding it." So the cardiologists refuse to have any kind of interest at all in nutrition, in lifestyle, in evidence-based supplements. They just not interested because it interferes with the money.
That's overwhelming for general people to understand, right?
Almost certainly. Yeah. You know, it's doctors have been revered for so many years, but I think a lot of people are a lot more skeptical now. I think the world is really awakening to the fact that doctors are brainwashed through medical school. Doctors are brainwashed into the pill and procedure model, a pill for every ill. And you know, people should trust their doctors when they're holistic doctors. So trust your chiropractor, trust your holistic and natural MD or DO or naturopath, trust your nutritionist, but also do your own research and see how that jives with you. But most importantly, Dr. Cho, is that just do what makes sense. It makes sense to live as much as we can like our ancestors did, eat the foods that they did, get the sleep that they did, get the sunshine that they did, get the, you know, live a stress-free lifestyle as much as possible. And I know this is so difficult in the 21st century, but it's the answers. It is the answers. And the power that you know, made the body can heal the body. And us medical doctors, we never get that. We never get that kind of training like a chiropractor does. And it's really exciting. It's very empowering for me. Like I said, I was so frustrated before because something was missing.
Right.
And now my patients that travel from all over the world that come to see me get just tremendous results. I had a woman actually who is a South Korean woman who came to see me. Her daughter lives in the San Francisco area, and she flew her mom out from South Korea to come see me.
Really?
And this story gets kind of funny because she's 83 years old.
Oh.
And she has high blood pressure. And I was doing my usual intake, and I'm, you know, asking all these different questions. And I said, what time do you normally go to sleep? Because it's normal to go to sleep with the sun down and awake with the sunrise. I said, ma'am, what time do you go to sleep? And she said, no, between 2 and 2:30 a.m. I said, what are you doing until 2 o'clock in the morning? She's 83 years old. And she says, well, you know, I'm on the internet and I'm on Facebook and I'm looking at my phone and I got my tablet and I was just amazed. So I tried to work with her to try and teach her, okay, you can't go to sleep at 2. You know, you got to start transitioning it to an earlier time, because when we are awake after dark, we are in the artificial light.
Right.
And that artificial light is so damaging to the body in ways we are just beginning to understand.
Can you elaborate like a little more on that? How it's damaging to our body? Does it interfere with our hormones or?
Yes, yes, yes. It interferes with the hormones tremendously. So what happens is that the artificial light is very high in what's called the blue part of the spectrum. Mm-hmm. And when we look at the sun, we see it's just a rainbow of light coming at us, and right. It's the red and the orange and yellow, green, etc. But the devices have been manufactured to be high on the blue scale. Mm-hmm. And that blue overload just goes into the eye, to the back of the eye called the retina. And then from there, it's supposed to fire onto the back of the brain, and it's supposed to hit the pineal gland eventually to make melatonin. And melatonin is the master hormone. Melatonin is the hormone that controls everything else. Testosterone, estrogen, progesterone, cortisol, insulin, thyroid, you name it. It is all controlled by the pineal and the melatonin. And when you have that artificial light, you destroy melatonin production. And then you have all these downstream health problems because of it. And all you have to do is go to sleep with the sun down and stay out of the artificial light at nighttime. And melatonin supplementation has been proven beneficial, not only for helping people sleep, but it lowers inflammation, lowers blood pressure. It's in the literature. It's been used in a lot of natural cancer regimens as well. But why not do it the natural way? And that's right. by getting sunshine and then going to sleep when you're supposed to. These devices are invented to keep us glued to them, right? So if we're watching TV, the light is there to keep us awake, to keep us watching more and more TV. That's why if you get into bed at 8 o'clock at night and you're reading a book, you can fall asleep very quickly.
Right.
Yet if you are watching TV, you can stay up all night watching TV, sure. you know, and it's a major, major health problem. So once again, it's all about educating people because people are being taught by the medical doctors that their blood pressure is high because they lack pharmaceuticals to bring it down, right? Like it's a pharmaceutical deficiency.
Right.
This is the mentality of what's going on. What our job is to teach people what the actual cause is. Now, what they want to do with that is up to them. If I want to say, hey, listen, I think caffeine is raising your blood pressure, you need to get off caffeine, stop drinking coffee. Well, some people would say, I would rather die than stop drinking coffee. And there's nothing we can do about that, but at least now we told them the truth because they didn't hear the truth from the medical doctor. They never even knew that it was a problem. So if we inform people, now they've been told the truth. It's just like smoking in the old days. People were said, hey, listen, smoking's great. You lose weight. 9 out of 10 doctors recommend, you know, XYZ cigarettes. And no one knew the truth. Well, once right. people found out the truth, now it is up to them to make a choice. Do you want to continue to smoke or not? And if you want to continue to smoke, that's okay. But understand that now you know the health consequences of that. Now, personally, I don't think it's okay to smoke because it is in the environment and it gets around other people and especially in front of the children. And that's a whole nother issue.
Gotcha. And what is your daily experiences like before and after? What changed the most?
Well, certainly my goal is to get people off of pharmaceuticals and to do so safely. When it comes to a statin drug, I can very easily just stop it on someone instantaneously and give them a new plan. When it comes to blood pressure drugs, sometimes we have to wean off that a little more slowly, remove those a little more slowly as we're adding in other nutrients. But once again, people do not have heart attacks because they are deficient in statin drugs or in aspirin. They do not have high blood pressure because they're deficient in blood pressure drugs. One of my favorite supplements that I use on people is really just a food, and it's organic beetroot powder. And beetroot powder is very high in something called nitrates that eventually open up all those blood vessels. People are deficient in beetroot. People are deficient in food-based nitrates to open up blood vessels. And once we teach them that and say, hey, with food and with these food-based supplements, this is what we can do. We can normalize your blood pressure. People flock to that message. They love that, and it totally makes sense, and it works. So why take a nasty pharmaceutical with all of the side effects to it when you can, once again, improve and be curative because you've found the cause? Another thing that I'm very big on is spices. All these different spices in your spice drawer, your spice cabinet, those are all natural pharmaceuticals. Those are all natural blood pressure lowering drugs. In fact, the pharmaceutical companies know this. They studied all those different plants and they came up with the drugs. And they found out what plants work. They changed the molecular structure, put a patent on it, and sold it for, you know, $100 billion. So I tell people, throw all the spices in the food and the rosemary and the thyme and the oregano, throw that all into the food and you get miraculous results.
So food and those natural substances and spices are your medicine?
Yes.
Yeah. What is your evaluation different than the conventional cardiologist?
I can explain this, obviously, because I've been both in my lifetime. I've been the conventional cardiologist, and here's how the conventional cardiologist looks at this situation. First off, the conventional cardiologist says, what kind of tests am I going to order on this guy? Because he's at higher risk. So what kind of tests do I want to do? And oh, by the way, I make a lot of money from ordering those tests. So I'm going to do a stress test, often with a nuclear injection. I'm going to do a cardiac ultrasound on this person. So I'm going to make money from doing those tests. And then, because he's got these risk factors, I'm going to put him on drugs. I'm going to put him on aspirin. I'm going to put him on a statin drug. I'm going to put him on a diabetes drug, on a blood pressure drug. So now this person is on at least, you know, four or five different pharmaceuticals. Obviously, my approach is totally different. I educate my people and say, listen, this is the nutrition that our ancestors did for millions of years when nobody had diabetes. We need to get sleep. We need to, because we know people that sleep 6 hours or less have a higher risk of high blood pressure, diabetes, and coronary artery disease. We need to get sunshine, because sunshine creates vitamin D, and high vitamin D lowers the risk of everything. Those artificial lights that we talked about, from the cell phones and the TVs, and even the overhead lights that we use, those destroy melatonin, and in doing so, destroy insulin function, so now you're diabetic. So once you educate people and tell them, a lot of people will make the change. Some people won't. Some people prefer to live in their little bubble of what they think is a different safe plan. But the thing is, Doc, is that their side, as you know, doesn't work. It doesn't work. The statin drugs can, you know, supposedly lowers cholesterol down, that's for sure. But does it lower your risk of heart attack, stroke, and dying? And the answer is, in some cases, yes, by this much. And when you tell people that, and that's what I talk about in my book is not about lowering your risk from here to here, it's lowering your risk to here. It's not about 7% versus 6%, it's about how do we find 0%. And in doing so, you make people happier.
Right.
You get rid of things like depression and anxiety and stress. You get rid of things like fatigue. You improve libido. You improve sexual function. Our product called beetroot powder, we also call that the boner juice, because it improves boners. It improves erectile function.
<It does. laughs>
And one of the ways it does so, once again, is that it increases nitric oxide.
Uh-huh.
And that opens up blood flow to everywhere where blood flow is needed.
Gotcha.
That's essentially the same way that a pharmaceutical like Viagra works.
Right.
In the sense that it increases nitric oxide.
Right.
So I would rather do that with beetroot than with some pharmaceutical.
I'm sure that you got a lot of your patients report the miracle in their point of view, but it's obviously not a miracle to you that you see all the time, right?
Well, you know, I think that the miracle refers to, the miracle is the human body. And when you take away all the poison that we're putting into the body from the air and the water and from the food, when you take away all that poison, the body is a miracle. The fact that we can, you know, run and jump and see and smell and feel and have, I mean, obviously it is a miracle.
Everything's interconnected.
Everything is interconnected. I mean, just, you know, as strange as it sounds, obviously, just as, you know, the person you're sitting in front of, I have energy that I'm radiating off to the world, and you have energy that you're radiating off to the world. And so often we miss that interpersonal connectedness,
right,
that we know from the medical literature that people need to be healthy.
Mm-hmm.
We know that massage is healthy,
right,
because of that touch element,
uh-huh,
amongst other things. And I think that is also a benefit of chiropractic, is that when you see the chiropractor and you're being touched by another human being, that there is healing qualities to that just in and of itself.
Mm-hmm.
And most people are, once again, culturally, they're just not getting that from other people. So many people are isolated. Maybe they don't have good family relationships or good friend relationships. And I think, once again, you know, bringing that back into the world, I think, is so, so important.
You nailed it. Yeah. Most of your patients are, should I say, pre-qualified? they kind of know what they're getting into with a certain expectation. It makes them very different than conventional heart patients. Thus, I'm expecting the patient compliance will be very high. That obviously will make your practice experience very rewarding. How's that?
Well, certainly, you know, what I tell is I tell people, you know, before they come to see me to read my book, The Paleocardiologist, The Natural Way to Heart Health. So read the book and kind of know what you're getting into to get educated. And therefore, when you come see me, you've already kind of, you know, you're already ahead of the game. What I offer to people over and above that, of course, is just a lot more personal nature to their individual needs, individual explanations, kind of, you know, reiterating what I said in my book, but then also by doing the most advanced blood testing in the world. So by looking at people's advanced lipids and markers of inflammation and a concept called leaky gut or omega-3 levels and thyroid and diabetes, really, really digging in deep, getting genetic information on people, heavy metals, you know, such as mercury, lead, arsenic, cadmium, going over and above what the typical doctor is doing. Heck, even at this point, Dr. Cho, is that most medical doctors, they don't even need to check labs. It's just a matter of, here, take the drugs, because I'm going to put you on the drugs anyways. There are most cardiologists believe that statin drugs such as Lipitor, Crestor, Zocor should be in the drinking water. So they don't need to test labs for anybody. But me, I like to give all that information and then come up with a comprehensive plan, and then we test 3 months later to see how we did. And when people follow the plan, 50% of the time, they get tremendous results. The more you follow Dr. Cho's plan, Wolfson's plan, the plan of a holistic doctor, the better your health is going to be.
Does your book covers like every aspect of heavy metal toxicities and thyroid, leaky guts? Did you go into that in your books?
I go into that very extensively in my book. I talk about leaky gut. Now, leaky gut is something I learned about from my wife in 2004. When she talked about it, I said, what kind of bogus or false diagnosis is that? And she said, well, go read up about it. Well, I tried to read up on it, and there really wasn't much in the literature. It made sense. But there wasn't much in the literature. Well, now over the last 10 years, the medical literature has exploded on the concept of leaky gut, also known as intestinal hyperpermeability. And now people have the ability to test for it. In fact, in my office, we do a test called the Wheat Zoomer, which is for leaky gut, and we do very well with that. And frankly, that's a test that people can order from my website, thedoctorswolfson.com, order the leaky gut, you know, Wheat Zoomer analysis, and we just send out the kit, and they can go to a local lab site and have that drawn. So
it's a blood test.
Simple blood test, one tube, looking for leaky gut. So now, it's as a cardiologist, it's absolutely amazing because we can see the progression. And of course, I talk about this in the book, that you have this leaky gut. Things get into the body that don't belong. And then the body reacts. And in that reaction process, it leads to disease. Heart disease, high blood pressure,
inflammation.
Dementia, inflammation, you name it. That leaky gut leads to immune activation and inflammation and oxidative stress, and then ultimately all of those factors lead to disease. Heart disease, cancer, dementia, you name it.
Elevation of cholesterol. And
yes, all that stuff has a reason, and that's up to the natural doctor to find that reason. Right. But I talk about all that stuff extensively in my book. My book has over 300 references. So it's not necessarily my opinion. It's the opinion of hundreds of other medical doctors and PhDs that wrote the original articles that I put together in my book as the references. But I think my book is a comprehensive plan. It's not just for the heart patient. It's not for someone who's already had a heart event, you know, although it does help those people. I want everyone to read it because I think it will prevent all disease by following the tenets in there. I have information in there, top 20 supplements, top 20 blood tests you need. So it's all in there in the book, and we talk about nutrition, and we talk about sleep, and we talk about sunshine. You had mentioned before about heavy metals. Heavy metals are linked to heart disease. Lead and mercury and arsenic and cadmium, they're all linked to heart disease. But the medical doctor, the typical cardiologist, doesn't care. If we are looking at our medical journal and it says lead and hypertension risk, boring. I want to know about the next drug. I want to know about the next test where I can make money. The doctors realize they've got nothing to do for lead toxicity. They are of no help in that scenario. And once again, it'd be so important to remove the source of lead, get the lead out of the body, and the person will heal.
Do you test heavy metal toxicity on your patients?
I do. I test it on everybody, and typically
everybody.
We do it by blood.
Yeah.
It can also be done through urine. It can be done through hair analysis, but I do a simple blood test. Sometimes I need to go a little bit further with a urine analysis, but for the most part, we just test it by blood. And then it's a matter of, well, how do we remove it from the person? Well, of course, you remove whatever the source may be of that exposure, and then you try and accentuate the body's own detoxification systems. Mm-hmm. And that's where things like garlic, things like chlorella, which is inside of my product Superfood, where using foods like onion and garlic and even garlic supplements, you know, to increase the detoxification pathways. It's
how
exciting.
For example, for garlic or chlorella, how does it detoxify the heavy metals?
Well, chlorella is a chelator. Chlorella, you know, binds up the metals in your intestinal tract and you poop it out the other side. The way that garlic and onion work is that they increase sulfur in the body, and sulfur is the main component to make what's called glutathione. And glutathione is made in the liver, and it attaches onto the heavy metal and takes it right out the door. So it's very exciting on how those products work. Vitamin C is tremendous in that same factor as well. I was reading something that vitamin C, low-dose vitamin C over a two-week period, decreased blood lead levels by over 50%.
Low-dose vitamin C.
Low-dose. It was under 400 milligrams. It wasn't one of these like 10-gram doses. It was tiny dosing that helps to flush the lead out of the body. Yeah. So how exciting is that to do what we do? And you can do it from a natural standpoint. And sure, you know, eat your citrus fruits and your berries. And my favorite source of vitamin C is avocado. Mm-hmm. Avocado is loaded with vitamin C. It's loaded with magnesium. It's loaded with potassium and, of course, fiber. Avocado is one of nature's perfect foods. One of the, I love eggs. Eggs are a multivitamin. Eggs are a cocoon for a baby chicken. They contain everything it needs for a chicken or a bird to come to life is inside of that egg. How can that not be healthy? It is. One of the things that's inside there that's so healthy is sulfur. And the sulfur that's inside there, once again, builds glutathione. Mm-hmm. Eggs, of course, contain lots of cholesterol, and cholesterol is so important for brain and body function. And that's why I mentioned cholesterol in chapter one of my book, The Truth About Cholesterol, because I want people to understand how important cholesterol is.
So detoxification, there are a lot of programs out there, right? Basically, you're doing the detoxification of your patients, but with your supplement, right?
Well, I think there's a lot of different ways to flush the toxins out of the body. And when we say toxins, what are we talking about? Sure, we're talking about metals like lead, aluminum, arsenic, cadmium, things that do not belong in the body. They have no physiologic purpose in the body and only inhibit the way it functions. So we want to move those things out. Plastics, other environmental pollutants that are in the air, that are in the water, that are in the soil. How do we get all that stuff out of the body? Well, the body is specifically has mechanisms to do so, and we want to give the tools it needs to get that done. And that's where just a multivitamin, you know, multivitamin that contains all the different nutrients to ramp up this toxin elimination. Drinking high quality water. My favorite water at this time is Pellegrino, because Pellegrino comes from Italy. It's a sparkling water, which is delicious. We buy it in a glass bottle, and it's very high, once again, in sulfur, which helps with detoxification. Now, I don't think we need to be drinking Pellegrino water all day long, but, you know, once again, just hydrating, which flushes all the bad stuff out of the kidneys.
It's as simple as hydration. It's also
hydration and moving the bowels, and sweating. We all know about the benefits of sauna therapy. So just getting a good sweat just helps to get all those environmental pollutants out of the body. You know, that's going to be really the mainstay. And then, yeah, there's some very exotic products that are out there, and some of it's marketing and some of it actually works. But it can be very simple. A lot of ways to go about that.
But isn't conventional medical doctors kind of sway away from the word detoxification?
Well, as we said, it's just we are fearful for what we don't understand, and we're not trained about anything regarding toxins. We don't talk about toxins in medical school. We don't talk about detoxification in medical school. We talk about pharmaceuticals, and we talk about procedures like angiograms and angioplasties and stents and bypass surgeries, and we talk about taking out people's gallbladders and their tonsils and their appendix. Right, right. That's what we talk about. We don't talk about health and wellness.
Is that why they're very open to food additives and artificial food?
We've got no nutrition training, so you know we can't say if it's good or bad. Now, I guess we would say that we've got some cursory knowledge that sugar would be bad, just like anybody who watches TV would know that drinking sugar-sweetened beverages would be bad. And therefore, it must be better to use an artificial sweetener. And I think clearly science and history is now proving all of that wrong. And we're clearly getting away from all that. And, you know, I'll take, for example, there's a blood thinner in the cardiology space called Coumadin. Right. The generic name is warfarin. And the way that works, it inhibits the function of vitamin K. And vitamin K makes our blood normal. It makes our blood, you know, clot when it's supposed to and not clot when it's, you know, doesn't, when it shouldn't. And they tell patients that are on Coumadin to avoid any food that contains vitamin K. Well, what are the foods that contain vitamin K? That's all the plants. Uh-huh. So how does this person stay healthy? I mean, should they be eating fast food and potato chips and ice cream and cookies? Well, none of those contain plants. So that's the diet that these people are now forced to adhere to. And it's something that I just never understood. So I told people, and I'm not giving medical advice here, obviously, but I tell people if they're on that drug, Coumadin, to eat lots of plants every day. So to be consistent with it. So you get all of the other benefit from the plants, but you will not get that vitamin K benefit, but you get everything else. Because otherwise they're just eating, you know, crackers, you know, and just garbage food. And that's a sure death sentence.
To replace the Coumadin, or those people who's taking Coumadin?
If you're taking Coumadin, then check with your doctor, because we can always put you on a higher dose of Coumadin, and yet eat those green vegetables every day. So the key to Coumadin is consistency, where every day you're eating those vegetables. Where you can get into trouble is if you were to eat vegetables every day for a week and then for the next week not have it, and therefore your levels would change on Coumadin. You know, really we want to work with our doctors in order to get the best foods into our bodies, no matter whatever the circumstance is. You know, so there's so many benefits to mushroom,
right.
And eating mushrooms, I would hate to see anyone avoid those because of some pharmaceutical drug.
Gotcha. You give out a lot of nutritional advice to your patients, right? But it does not mean it's necessarily a supplementation. And supplementation market out there is like a jungle. Do you have any recommendations to what to like watch out for or what to look for when people going into like supplement themselves?
Great question. So the word supplement means like an add-on. So, and that's exactly what supplements are. They're an add-on to a healthy lifestyle. So, eat the right foods, get the sleep, get the sunshine, get the stress out, get chiropractic, get hydrated, get happy. Do all those things. And in addition, there are some evidence-based supplements that can be very beneficial. Because even on the best diets, the soil, you know, is not normal. The water is not normal. The air is no longer normal. This is not paradise of 10,000 years ago. And we have to take evidence-based supplements in order to make sure we're getting all the nutrients that we need, because it's deficient in the food. It's just the way that it is. So, you know, I mean, I think it's very important to do very quality products, because if it's not a quality product from a quality company, that you know you can trust, you're going to get something inferior that's not going to work, and you're wasting your money. So, for example, the stuff that we carry on our website, we've done all the research. The companies that we use are the best companies on the planet that are doctors' line companies, that we get the results. when you go to just your local drugstore or, you know, pharmacy and pick up any kind of product over there, you're likely getting something that's inferior. So check with a good holistic doctor for advice on quality products. It's always a good place to start.
I talked to Dr. Cho on the way here, but the people with hypertension who are taking medication, they're somewhat relieved that, you know, they're both
instant relief of like,
to be, like stabilized.
Yeah.
But once they're got off the medication and maybe doing the right like a diet, but then how soon can patient would experience or the improvement, see the improvement or the effect?
Patients can improve very quickly, and we see this. I see this in my office all the time. And the problem with the pharmaceuticals, they give people a false sense of security because the blood pressure drugs lower the number down
almost instantly, right?
Blood pressure drugs?
Yes.
Blood pressure drugs work in some people, and they don't work in others. I mean, they're not perfect by any stretch, but the numbers are lowered down. But we don't care about numbers. We care about, is the pill I'm taking, is it going to lower my risk of heart attack, stroke, kidney disease, dying? That's what matters. It's not about the number.
Right.
And the reality is that the pharmaceuticals can lower numbers down, but they do not change outcomes. They do not have a meaningful difference in heart attack or stroke prevention because they don't go after the cause. They're a Band-Aid approach. So when I give someone organic beetroot powder, my greens powder, my superfood, and we put them on magnesium or a multivitamin or omega-3 fish oil or garlic, we're giving people what they need. We achieve the number reduction very quickly, and there's no doubt we are making that person normal. If I tell someone to go out into the sun and get tons of sunshine, one of the benefits is to raise vitamin D. And that does so many amazing things, and that happens instantaneously. So people's blood pressures can change very quickly. Just with a chiropractic adjustment, you can drop blood pressure 10, 15 points in an instant. Meditation, you know, Tai Chi, Qigong, you know, these other autonomic, you know, activities can help to really restore blood pressure and normalize it.
Isn't a lot of patients that say that? Pill is much easier.
A pill
then changing the lifestyle
definitely seems like it's a lot easier, but people need to understand that it's not doing the same thing. It's just a Band-Aid approach.
It's a false sense of security, right?
It's definitely a false sense of security. And once people learn the truth and they say, wait a second, I'm taking this drug and it's lowering my numbers down, but it's not really changing my risk of heart attack, stroke, and dying, then why am I taking this? So, and once again, doctor, it's about educating people and telling them the truth. What they do with the truth, if they say, you know what, I'm going to keep living my lifestyle. I'm going to keep eating bad food, and I'm not going to sleep, and I'm not going to get sunshine. I'm not going to do these things. I'm just going to take the pill. Okay.
Can't help them, right?
That's up to them. And some people like that, you can't help. But all we can do is continue to try, continue to educate. And, you know, maybe they read my book, and then maybe they see somebody on television, or maybe they read my book, and then they watch your next podcast. And then hopefully eventually they see the light. They hear the truth enough times that they start to make a difference.
Well, sometimes they find out too late, like after all the side effect and the suffering.
Yep. But it's never too late. It's never too late, right? It's just like someone who smokes. You know, if you say, well, I've smoked for 40 years, what good does it do now to quit? It does a ton of good. We know that. We know that people that quit after 40 years live a lot longer than the people who don't. So there's always the ability to make a difference. No matter how old you are, you can still go see a holistic doctor. You can still get chiropractic care, no matter what your situation is.
Do you have any example of like one of your worst patient case study? Can you go into it?
Well, you know, and this is on, you know, one of my testimonials where I saw a patient a few years ago. He was over 500 pounds and he was facing gastric bypass surgery. He was going to have surgery to remove 3/4 of his stomach. Can you imagine that? Yeah. I mean, that people would actually go for a procedure like that. And he came to see me as a cardiologist to make sure he was safe for the surgery. And I said, listen, you're not safe for the surgery, but go ahead and do it. There's nothing I can do about your lack of safety. But before you go, I just want to write down some stuff. And I didn't have the book and I didn't have my fancy paleo pyramid. I just wrote down some stuff. And I never saw him again until 3 years later, I got a letter in the mail. And the letter in the mail had a before picture where he's over 500 pounds and then an after picture where he was under 200 pounds. He lost 300 pounds in 3 years. And he said, dear Dr. Wolfson, I never had the bypass gastric surgery. I followed your information about paleo nutrition and I lost over 300 pounds. To me, that's very exciting. That's very, very rewarding to be able to do something like that. Now, you may say, well, it's a heck of a lot easier to do, you know, to do surgery. But once again, it's not near the same. His outcomes, you know, his life will be a lot longer than someone who had 3/4 of their stomach
Absolutely.
Removed.
Yeah. And quality of life can't imagine. I heard that if you have a bypass surgery, your diabetes will be gone because your insulin resistance will go down.
Yes.
Yeah.
And that's, I mean, and that's
probably
certainly,
that's not the only way, right?
Well, no, I mean, and that's certainly true, you know, I mean, and, you know, I guess I would also say if I removed your liver, you'll never have liver disease,
right?
You know,
like I can't have a
yes.
cervical cancer. Huh?
If you remove all the organs, right, your gallbladder won't burst if we remove it ahead of time. You know, once again, I think that, you know, there is evidence that you can find some benefit to any of these medical procedures, but there's risk, as you know, associated with it, and it's not the answer. The answer is to go after cause. So clearly these people are vitamin deficient, nutrient deficient when they have gastric bypass surgery or lap band. You never know what the long-term ramifications of that are, and we're just beginning to see what it is. You know, so sure, you may get rid of diabetes, but what do they do to their brain? What do they do to, you know, their neurologic, you know, nervous system? There's a better way, and the answer is to eat the right foods. And it's not easy. You know, we often go for the quickest approach, but it's the answer.
What's your thought on the bypass surgery or stent heart surgery?
Well, I talk about it in the book, and what I want people to understand there is that what stents and bypass surgery regarding the heart are for is for symptoms relief. Mm-hmm. So somebody is having chest pain when they climb up a flight of stairs, or they're having sexual intercourse and they have chest discomfort. If you want to have a stent placed for that, that's fine. But understand, it's not preventing a heart attack. It's not preventing you dying. It's for your symptoms. And I think when people understand that, then they'll be a little more reluctant to just have a procedure done and say, well, you know, you have a blockage, but I feel fine. But you know, we should probably fix that blockage. Why? It's, you know, according to the literature and according to Wolfson's book, it's not saving lives. So I think there's a time and a place for those procedures, but they're done way, way, way too often, and they do it for money.
All right. I want to go into supplementation a little bit. I know you use other manufacturers, but you also have your own lines.
Yes.
Most of them I noticed that it's on a powder form.
Mm-hmm.
And is there any reason why you prefer the powder over the tablets or the capsule?
Well, the three main products that I take every morning, and so does my wife and so do my two boys, we call it the triple combo, and that's our Daily Greens, Superfood, and the beetroot powder. And those powders we mix together in water, and that is our breakfast. And we want those powders to come in like food, because that is the best way for the body to digest those foods, to break down those foods. And we want the oral bacteria in our mouths and the saliva in our mouths to start the digestive process, the activation of the nutrients in there. And that's why I love the food-based powders. And it's also part of the food budget. They have calories to it. So it's not about just swallowing a bunch of capsules, although I think in a lot of scenarios that capsules are necessary, but the foundation of what we do really is the greens, the beetroot, the superfood. I think everybody should be taking a multivitamin, everybody should be taking a probiotic, and then also supplementing with omega-3 fish oil. So there are a handful of basics that people need. People need, anyone who's over the age of 30, 35 years old, they need digestive enzymes to help break down that food. Once again, when people do that, we get extraordinary results.
How is it compared to the juicing, the actual vegetable and fruit, the your powders?
Well, I think that juicing is fantastic, but juicing can be more difficult. Mm-hmm. It can be more expensive. And I guess if there is one thing I would be critical about, it's the fact that the powders contain fiber and the juices typically don't. It's just very simple. You know, you take a scoop out, you throw it into the water, and it's very easy for people to do, and I think cheaper. People that buy the juices, first of all, it better be organic, because if you're not drinking an organic juice, you're concentrating all those pesticides that do so much damage, obviously, to the good bacteria that we're talking about. So do not drink pesticide juice. It has to be organic and preferably in glass. Mm-hmm. And we always, once again, try and stay away from plastic, because it is linked to cardiovascular disease. It is linked to cancer. It is linked to hormone disruption, you know, interfering with testosterone, estrogen, progesterone. Function.
For your chlorella and spirulina, where do you get from?
A lot of our products come from different places, and they're all organic certified as far as our chlorella and spirulina. So sometimes they come from overseas, sometimes they can be from North America, sometimes from the United States, but everything is all verified as far as, you know, third-party testing. But I tell you, the testing that I do is on my patients, and I see the results they get with our products. That's the most important thing.
Right.
When it comes to the supplementation, I test people's levels for toxins and heavy metals.
Side effect of the nutrition, or can you go into that?
It's very uncommon for people to have a side effect from a nutritional supplement. A lot of it, we can say, would be maybe kind of a detox reaction where they're starting to, you know, as the body's cleansing itself of the poisons, that can be an issue. So I think it is important to work with a good holistic provider to be able to help people through that. And like we talked about before, to stay well hydrated and make sure your bowels are moving, and sauna and massage and things like that. Chiropractic care, that's also important when it comes to detoxification. But I worked in the hospitals, doctor, for over 16 years. The amount of times I saw someone come in with a vitamin overdose, zero. It doesn't happen. People come in 1,000 times a day across the United States with a pharmaceutical side effect or overdose or some issue with that, including people dying from pharmaceuticals. Once again, they're not dying from the nutritional supplements.
So it almost feels like you don't need the malpractice insurance anymore.
Well, you know, listen, I think it would be, if someone had a bad outcome, it would be very difficult to prove it on my vitamin D supplement. If someone had a bad outcome, they couldn't say it was from my organic beetroot powder. So, and I think that the reality is that society is very litigious, and there are a lot of lawsuits, but let's just say that I have not had any problems over the many years that I've been doing this with any of my patients.
Because you're with the happier patients.
They're happier patients, and they're healthier, and they're getting the results. It's just because when you give the body what it needs, it works. And once again, people are happier, they're healthier, so they're not looking to sue a holistic doctor. Pretty good?
What about the cost?
The cost. The typical medical doctor obviously falls under insurance. And it's often been said, obviously, you get what you pay for. Mm-hmm. But even the insurance-based doctors, people still have to come up with a lot of out-of-pocket expenses and co-pays and deductibles. In my office here, it's a cash-based practice. A lot of the advanced testing I do is covered very well by insurance, but my fees are all in cash.
The consultation is, you don't take insurance?
I don't take
insurance. You can, but you don't.
I don't take insurance because insurance does not pay for the quality that I provide.
Oh,
my initial consultations.
Your consultation gotta be like 10 minutes. to be covered by insurance.
And that's how it is in a conventional cardiology practice. It's a 10-minute office visit.
Right.
In my practice, when you come to see me, it's typically a 90-minute office visit. It's an hour and a half for me to explain everything to you, for me to go over these things, and then for me to examine you and to do the testing that we need and recommend the tests and explain what we're doing. And then when I see you in follow-up, we explain and we talk about the results. It's hard to put a price tag on how important that is on this life-saving information. I mean, it's... but it's the way the medical system is rigged right now to the insurance model. But I've got patients, once again, from all over the world. I've got a 3-month waiting list for people to come see me. I always see emergencies very quickly, but we are booked out for so long because people want this kind of quality care that they're not getting from their doctor.
People are waking up. It's kind of sad. A lot of people like let their insurance dictate their health, you know. They're only ones looking for the anything that's covered by insurance, then they're going to it. And if not covered, they kind of like withdraw it.
I mean, listen, 75 years ago, there was no insurance. Everybody, you know, saw each other and they paid cash or they did some kind of trade or barter. And I think that's how society, it'd be nice if it went down to that, if we all had some kind of catastrophic insurance. But when it came to day-to-day health and wellness, yeah, you know what, Dr. Cho, I want to come see you. I want an adjustment. What are your fees? Oh, well, I charge X amount of dollars for, you know, an adjustment, and I decide if that's appropriate for me. If I want to be healthy, I'll say yes.
Yeah, there you go. It's going to be the last question. Are you associated with the American Academy of Integrative Medicine or Functional Medicine? Where do you get all your information from, other than your wife, Heather?
Well, you know, first of all, I get my information now from mainstream medical literature. I'm digging into the literature to find out all the things that I missed as a medical student, resident, and a fellow. And on a day-to-day basis, I get updates about all the different supplements and lifestyle changes and how they work. But fundamentally, my information now just comes from what makes sense. It comes from Mother Nature. Just do it the way our ancestors did it. And there are governing bodies now. There's a lot of other holistic doctors and holistic societies. I did 96 hours of continuing education from a group called the American Academy of Anti-Aging. So the holistic doctors are out there. There's more of us coming along, and we are here to stay. And the truth will be heard.
Great. Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.
Appreciate it, doctor. Pleasure to meet you.